employees and governor generals. Very important. But how to prepare these governor generals from 1757 to 1947? Almost 200 years. Almost 200 years. Now the formula which you have to apply is, you divide modern India into two parts. This part, East India Company. So in this part you will find two people. Pay attention. Creators and consolidators. Who's a creator? Clive and Dupley. Who's a consolidator? Warren Hastings and Cornwallis. Formula. Simple formulas. In this phase, you will find creators, consolidators. One came and created, other came and consolidated. Clive, Dupley, creators. Or Dupley and Clive, you can write any one of your choice. Warren Hastings and Cornwallis, consolidators. Wellesley and Hastings, creators. Lord Hastings. Wellesley and Lord Hastings, creators. William Bentinck and Dalhousie, consolidators. William Bentinck and Dalhousie, consolidators. Finished. On the basis of this formula, C is equal to C, you can remember at least 100 facts. Formula. You prepared in this way? No. That is why you take the stress and strain, na? That is why the most important question of prelims is common sense and elimination. Because four types of questions I told you. Facts, concepts, elimination, common sense. So in these four types, two is based on studying, two is based on understanding. Those who study, they disqualify. Those who study and understand, they qualify. To 1947. These are part of crown. Instigators. Pacifiers. Canning. And Lytton, instigator. Canning and Lytton, instigator. Ripon, pacifier. Huh? Dufferin, Curzon, instigator. Minto, divide and rule. Reading, Chelmsford, instigators. Irwin, pacifier. plus plus the viceroys of final phase Mahabharat. First viceroy Nilitigo, second Wewel, third very famous Mountbatten. This is the formula. You can prepare minimum 500 questions in a very easy way. And if you fail to prepare, you can do it by your common sense and process of elimination when you see the question. If you see the question about creation, you know who has created. If you know the question, see the question of consolidation, you know who has consolidated. Even that is a point to tick the answer. Those who study, they don't qualify prelims. Those who study, understand and have the art of handling the pressure, they qualify. Prelims is a game of three things: studying, understanding and pressure. Let's start. Who among the following committed suicide? First, answer A, Robert Clive. He died in a mysterious condition. No one is clear how he died. He was facing corruption charges there in England, but that was not the reason for committing suicide. Basically, he suffered from a mysterious illness. So there are many opinions about it, ki possibly he took the wrong drug or he knowingly took the drug. So he committed suicide because of mysterious illness. Answer is 1A. Second, what was true about Robert Clive, creator? He was the governor of Fort William in 1756. Yes, he was given the prize for his achievement in Carnatic. He became the governor general, governor of Bengal in 1765. True, he was recalled back after Buxar. He established Society of Trade, true, to handle the menace of Dastak. He was a advisor to Mir Jafar as a Nawab of Bengal, officially not. Answer is B, 1, 2, 3. Consider the following statements. Treaty of Allahabad was a great achievement of Clive, true. Three shots by a single arrow. Three shots. First shot, Shah Alam. He takes Diwani from him. Second shot, Shuja-ud-Dawla. He makes him friend, come slave. So Treaty of Allahabad was a great achievement, true. Dual government was a smart move of Clive, 1765 to 1772. No one knew that company has turned into a political power in India. And this was very beneficial for company because before the rivals knew, they consolidated their position. The third answer, C. Covenanted civil service was started by Clive. Covenanted means civil service with condition. 1765, company becomes a political power. So now they require civil servants. Necessity is the mother of invention. Fourth answer is A. Fifth, white rebellion during Clive was a revolt of soldiers. Soldiers, they revolted for double bhatta. Clive said, this bhatta will be given only to the soldiers working outside Bihar and Bengal, otherwise it will not be given. And then the soldiers stationed at Monger revolted. This was white mutiny. Fifth answer A. Six, very important. The famous governors of Bengal and important events. Cartier, first famine of modern India in Bengal, took place during his period. Versalet was during dual government. Vansittart was the governor during Battle of Buxar. And Holwell narrates the story of black hole tragedy. Answer is D. 6D. 7. Consider the following statements. Maharaja Nandakumar trial was during the period of Warren Hastings. Yes, true. Warren Hastings was the first governor general of India. False. Nandakumar. He basically became the victim. He went on the side of the rivals of Warren Hastings and he accused Warren Hastings of bribery. Ki Warren Hastings has taken 3.5 lakh rupees from Munni Begum, the mother of Mubarak Abdullah, and then made him the Nawab of Bengal. This was the blame of Nandakumar on Warren Hastings. And then Warren Hastings immediately went against him. He accused him of forgery. And Warren Hastings' friend, Elijah Empe, was the Chief Justice of Supreme Court. So morning the case was filed, evening the trial was done, afternoon, evening hanging. And this case is called as judicial murder. Nandakumar. So seventh answer is A. Only A is true. Consider the following statements. Clive took away Allahabad and Kara from Avadh by the Treaty of Allahabad. True. Clive succeeded in turning Shah Alam as the pensioner of company. True. Dual government established by Clive was so much oppressive that the weavers chopped off their thumbs. True. Clive succeeded in ending the private trade by the workers of company. True. All are true. Ninth, all these treaties, Banaras, Faizabad, very important. Core of the treaty. 1772, Board of Revenue was established. 1765, company gets Diwani of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. They were foreigners in India. They did not knew the political and economic structure. So they appointed a deputy Diwan. Who was Deputy Diwan? Shitab Roy. But when Warren Hastings comes, he wanted to control the revenue so that he can give promotion to the other projects. So they end the office of Deputy Diwan and establishes Board of Revenue. 1784, Asiatic Society of Bengal. Again, they were foreigners. They have to understand polity, economy and culture of India. For that, they have to translate Indian scriptures. This was the objective of Asiatic Society of Bengal, which led to the translation of Gita, Hitopadesh, Fatwa-e-Alamgiri, etc. 1773, Treaty of Banaras. Very important. He takes away Banaras. Company takes away Banaras. 1775, Treaty of Faizabad. By this treaty, Nawab was declared as the guardian of the wealth of Begum of Awadh. So answer is D. Ninth D. Who among the following was related to Warren Hastings? Maharaja Nandakumar, Chat Singh. I said Treaty of Banaras, company takes away Banaras, and Chat Singh directly came under the command of company and he was ordered to give 22 lakh per annum. But then finally Warren Hastings plays the game and takes away Banaras from Chat Singh. Hafiz Rahmat Khan, yes, he was the ruler of Ruhelkhand who was defeated in the battle of Miranpur Katra. Elijah Empe was the Chief Justice of Supreme Court established during his time. All of them. Answer is A. 11. Consider the following statements. Consider the following. For Warren Hastings, Mughal Emperor Shah Alam has no value. True. He called him the King of Shreds and Patches. Warren Hastings forced Asafuddallah to plunder Begums of Awadh. Yes. Actually, he was indebted 15 lakh rupees to the company. Maratha war has depleted the wealth of company. So he has to take the money. So he turns towards Asafuddallah. Ki give me back my money. Asafuddallah was not having money. So he says, fine. You take away the money of the Begums of Awadh. So C, 11th C, both are true. What was true about Warren Hastings? He failed to make proper revenue reforms. Proper. That is true. He failed to make proper revenue reforms. He experimented in land revenue, he failed. Quinquennial settlement. But he establishes the custom duties, 5 custom houses. And that to a level was able to manage the custom duties. So finally, what Cornwallis did, he simply started it. Warren Hastings established Diwani and Fauzdari Adalat at district level, true. Only 5 custom houses were maintained by him, true. All the zamindars having the right to collect custom duty were ended. Only 5 custom houses to give promotion to trade and commerce. Exploitation of the weavers by the company, by the company's agent, true. Although he tried to overcome it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, all are true. Question number 12, all are true. 13, Cornwallis Code is related to judicial reforms. Very important. Why it is important? Because he establishes judiciary on the principle of separation of power. Two things he did in judiciary. First thing, establishment of judiciary on the principle of separation of power. Because he says, if a judge gets a judicial and police power, that will be very harmful for the people. And second thing he did, gradation of courts in Bengal. As we have today, Supreme Court, Higher Court, High Court, Lower Court, Session Court. So answer is B, judicial reforms. District collector will be responsible for revenue. And district judge will be responsible for judiciary. 14th, criminal law reforms of Cornwallis was mainly humanitarian. True. He ended that chopping off of hands for theft, etc., etc. Cornwallis tried to handle corruption and bribery in an efficient way by increasing the salary and giving commission. So the salary of civil servant was 1500. 1793 plus 1% commission. So 14th answer C. What was true about permanent settlement? Zamindars were declared as the owners of the land, true. Arsidat supported permanent settlement, true. Rajaram Mohan Roy wanted permanent settlement with farmers also, true. It was implemented in Bengal, Bihar, Orissa, parts of eastern UP, true. Answer is 15, answer A. Consider the following statements. Permanent settlement, very important move of Cornwallis. Because this is the phase when company is passing through consolidation. And for consolidation, you require money. That too, stable source of income. Your father says, go to Delhi, prepare for IAS, I'll give you 50,000. In the first month, he sends you 5,000. This happened with the company. Company became the victim of financial crisis. Takes the loan of 10 lakh pound from Bank of England. So permanent settlement is very important. 15th A. 16th, consider the following statements. Cornwallis regarded every native of Hindustan to be corrupt. True. The doors of covenanted civil service were closed for Indians. True. Cornwallis had a low opinion about Indian character, ability and integrity. True. Reason. He has to promote Europeans. Now when you prepare Cornwallis, one thing should be in mind. What is he? Consolidator. So he will consolidate polity, he will consolidate economy, he will consolidate the general features of company. 16 answer is A, all are true. 17. What was true about police reforms of Cornwallis? Police, the main organ to control the state. Army is for enemies, police is for civilians. Before Cornwallis, the law and order was in the hand of zamindars. But when you have to exploit, you cannot rely on others. So he created a modern police service. He is the father of modern police service in India. Cornwallis. Districts were divided into thanas, true. Every thana had a daroga, true. Zamindars of the area to assess the daroga is false. SP was the head of the thana, true. 1, 2 and 4. 17th answer, D. Subsidiary alliance. So India was not occupied by army. India was occupied by three formulas. Very important. And you have to know about those three formulas. East India Company did not occupy India by army. East India Company occupied India by three formulas. First formula, formula of kingmaker. Interfere in the affairs of Indian rulers and then have economic and political gains. Second Carnatic War. Second formula, subsidiary alliance. To place all the idiots on the local thrones. And third formula, doctrine of lapse. EIC occupied India by these three formulas. Formula of kingmaker, subsidiary alliance and doctrine of lapse. So you have to be aware about doctrine, subsidiary alliance. 18th answer is A. What, why, who were the rulers? Just note it down. We have a time limitation. So we can give you a very good frame of these things, but you have to do the homework by yourself. So don't leave it here. You also complete the paper. 19. Wellesley established Fort William College for civil servants. 19. D. 20. First Anglo-Nepal War was fought during the time of war. Lord Hastings. This Gurkha army, they used to enter into the Tarai region. And the border between India and Nepal was not clear. So he has to specify the borders. And that was followed by Treaty of Sagauli. 1816, very important Treaty of Sagauli. Treaty of Sagauli. 1816. So by this treaty, the Gurkhas accepted the British resident in Kathmandu and handed over Tarai region and Dune area. B. 21. Consider the following statement. Till 1835, the company's coins carried the stamp of Emperor Shah Alam. True. Reason, 1833 Charter Act. Sole control moved into the hand of Board of Control. So now the new power in India is Board of Control. And currency is the medium to express who's the new power. Akbar II was the Mughal emperor who received Lord Hastings on equal status. No. Lord Hastings wanted this, but then Akbar II met Lord Amherst in 1827. Rajputana came under the control of the company during Lord Hastings. True. Maratha Confederacy was dissolved by Lord Hastings, Third Anglo-Maratha War. Answer is 134. 21 D. 22. Which of the following statements are true about Lord Hastings? Very important. Who is he? Creator. Just keep in mind, he is a creator. He relaxed press restrictions, abolishing press censorship on press. True. Malwadi system was included during his, introduced during his period. True. Collector in Bengal presidency was allowed to hold the office of the magistrate also. This was the reform which he did in Cornwallis setup. Rajdwari system was introduced in South during his tenure. True. All are true. 22A. Who were the important personalities at the time of Lord Hastings? Very important. Sir John Malcolm, administrator. Sir Thomas Munro, governor of Madras, 1820.
who is responsible for introducing Rayatwari system. Elphinstone, governor of Madras, 1819, who introduced Rayatwari and Mahalwari in South. Charles Metcalfe, negotiator between Rajputana and company, all of them. 23A, 24, Governor General's events, important events. There are thousands of events, important. First Anglo-Afghan War, Lord Auckland. Sin, company faced condemnation on it. So you have to be aware who was the Governor General. Allen Barrow, annexation of Sindh. A, answer is 2. B, answer is 1. C, answer is 3. D, answer is 4. First Anglo-Sikh War. 24, answer C. What was true about the period of William Bentinck? Consolidator. Again, write on these questions. Consolidator. William Bentinck, consolidator. End of discrimination of government jobs. Section 687. Very important. No discrimination. Section 87 of Charter Act of 1833. No discrimination on the basis of religion, race, or color. End of Thagi tradition. True. End of female infanticide, true. End of Devadasi system, answer is 1, 2, 3, 25B. Who opposed abolition of Sati system? Dev Samaj. Who was the leader, head of Dev Samaj? Radhakant Dev. 27, consider the following statements. Regulation number 17 of December 1829, very important. Sir, every fact of this line is important because Sati system was a very big menace for the female gender. Regulation number 17 of December 1829 declared Sati as a culpable homicide. True. Section 87 of the Charter Act of 1833 was related to jobs and employment. True. 27 answer is C. During the time of William Bentinck, for the convenience of the public of Upper Province and Delhi, a separate Sadar Nizamat and Sadar Diwani Adalat was established at Allahabad. It was not possible for the people of UP and all this area to go to Calcutta every time. So Allahabad was established. 28B. 29, consider the following statement. Judiciary got renovated and transformed during William Bentinck. Yes. A person can file a case in Persian or vernacular. And Persian as a court language was replaced by English. William Bentinck followed the policy of non-interference completely towards the Indian states. No. He followed it as far as possible. Because during his time, Mysore, Coorg and Chachar were annexed. You have to take out the reasons why. So 29 answer is A. 30. What was true about William Bentinck? Consolidator. He supported the claims of Shah Shuja on the throne of Kabul. William Bentinck comes to India in which year? 1835 to 1835. Russia is trying to move on Silk Route, so William Bentinck has to take that precaution. So friendly ruler in Afghanistan, Shah Shuja, in case that fails, see, he did commercial treaty with Amir of Sindh, precaution. In case that also fails, he did a treaty of perpetual friendship with Ranjit Singh. Precaution. He opted the policy of interference in Jaipur. No. In spite of the attack on British resident, he did not interfere in the matter of Jaipur. So answer is 30, answer is D. What was not true about William Bentinck? D. Who among them were related to William Bentinck? Raja Ram Mohan Roy, social reformer who played an important role in the end of Sati system. William Sleeman, very important. He is the officer in charge against thugs. William Sleeman. Robert Martin's Bird. Robert Martin's Bird. Land revenue reforms of Northwestern Province. Patta and Kubuliyat. Macaulay, the god of modern education. Answer is A, all of them. 31A. 32. A single shelf of a good European library was worth the whole native literature of India and Arabia, was the famous quote of Macaulay. This was the to counter Orientalist, as they were against modern education in English medium. 32, answer is D. 33, consider the following statements. Financially, the period of William Bentinck was a period of loss for the state. True. Reason? Burma War. Burma War depleted the territory. So, Burma War. So he has to recover. A very important development in financial system by Bentinck was regularization and licensing of opium trade. Press was in advantage during the time of William Bentinck. True. He called press as a safety valve. So 32, answer is D. 33, answer is B. Both are true. Calcutta Medical College was established during the time of William Bentinck. 35, William Bentinck. Now this is again a factual question. Important events of Governor Generals. So 35, answer is D. 36, the annexation of which state of India was met with universal condemnation? Sin. Even Charles Napier says it will be considered as an idiocy, but we are compelled to do this idiocy because sin were the loyal servants from the very beginning. 37A, who was the first Governor General to get veto power? Cornwallis. He came to India on this condition, okay, I want veto power. 38. Now please, possibly there is a printing mistake in this question. So please all of you correct it. You have to make the answer schedule here. IQRA is sorry for this inconvenience. Please just do it as a change. According to Dalhousie, 38, the bullock cart civilization of India got following engines of social improvement. Railways, uniform postage, and electric telegraph. So you do one thing, you create the answer for it. Answer is all of them. B, 1 and 2. C, 1, 2 and 3. D, 1 and 4. You please put the answer C, 1, 2 and 3. IQRA is again sorry, and I am also sorry. I have framed it. It was basically my mistake. So I am sorry to all of you, but please do the correction. 39, answer is A, all of them. Which of the following was annexed by EIC during the period of Dalhousie? Punjab, Burma, Sikkim, Avadh. Punjab, Burma and Sikkim directly annexed. Avadh, doctrine of lapse. Doctrine of lapse. Wajid Ali Shah. Punjab, Sikkim and Burma were annexed. Avadh was annexed on the grounds of maladministration. This was a challenge in front of Dalhousie because he was having number of children. Maladministration. Answer is A. 39A. 40. Now the rulers who went off because of doctrine of lapse. It's a factual question. You have to remember these rulers. So 40 answer is A. 41, who became the victim of Dalhousie's abolition of title and pension program? Very important. Karnatic, Tanjore, Mughals, Peshwa, all of them. But you have to do the value addition. You cannot leave it like this. I have said I have the limitation of time. 42, consider the following statements. In spite of the loyalty of Nizam, of Hyderabad also became the victim of Dalhousie. True. Actually, Nizam was in debt of East India Company. So Dalhousie takes away Berar, cotton producing area. Avadh was cheated by Dalhousie. Yes. Maladministration. Both are true. 42C. 43. Non-regulation system evolved by Dalhousie to administration. A large part of India was annexed. So, how you will administer these areas? So, under non-regulation system, he appoints a commissioner in the newly conquered area, and that commissioner was directly responsible to Governor General. That was called as non-regulation system. So, 43 answer is A. 44 answer is A. What is true about Dalhousie? I said important contributions and achievements. 44 answer is A. 45. What was true about Wood's dispatch under Dalhousie? Very important. This dispatch is called as Magna Carta of modern education in India. Who laid down the foundation? Macaulay. Recommended Anglo-Vernacular schools throughout the districts? True. Government colleges of higher grade in important towns? True. University in all the three presidencies? True. Public educational department? True. All are true. 45A. 46. Who was the first Governor General of India? William Bentinck. First Governor General of Bengal? Warren Hastings. First Governor General and Viceroy? Canning. 46D. 47. Who among the following started his career as a clerk in EIC? Robert Clive. How Robert Clive became the hero? Second Anglo-Carnatic War. When he succeeds in Arcot episode. Who established Madras? Francis Day. 1639. Madras was taken from the King of Chandragiri on lease. 48 answer is A. 49. What was the popular name of EIC? Very important. This company ruled for 100 years. Company of Merchants of London. C. 50. Consider the following statements. Ripon safeguarded British interest in India and won the heart of Indians. Consolidator. Right in bracket immediately consolidator. Canning was the first Viceroy of India. Both are true. 50C. 51. Consider the following statement. Florence Nightingale called Ripon as the savior of India. True. Madan Mohan Malviya called him as beloved by Indians. True. S.N. Banerjee said he revived political life in India. Three statement, three personalities. See the background in which Ripon comes. Lytton comes to suppress the rising national tide of national movement in India. And then he irritates every section in India. Vernacular Press Act, Arms Act, Delhi Darbar. He comes to suppress the tide of national movement. He provokes it. When Ripon comes, he satisfies every section. He bothers about the interest of welfare of middle class, common people. So Florence Nightingale calls him savior of India. Madan Mohan Malviya called him a beloved of Indians. He satisfies the interest of every section. Hunter Commission 1882, interest of educated middle class,
reduction in the salt duty, local self-government. And S.N. Banerjee said that he revived political life. Ilbert Bill controversy gave momentum to, he revived political life. S.N. Banerjee says he revived political life. 1883, Ilbert Bill controversy. 1883, National Fund. 1883, National Conferences. And in this background, 1885, Indian National Congress. 1, 2, 3, 51A. What was true about Ilbert Bill controversy? Very important. This bill became the background for the birth of Congress. So you have to know about this bill. It was related with the issue of Mr. Bihari Lal Gupta, true. It was related to judiciary, true. Bihari Lal Gupta was law member of Viceroy's Executive Council, false. The whole story ended up with the resignation of Rippon as a Viceroy, 1, 2 and 4. 52D, match the following. 53, answer is B. Important events during the time of Rippon. First Factory Act, 1881. It applied to the factory having 100 plus workers. Children below 7 years of age were not allowed to work. For children of 12 years, working hour was fixed. Appointment of inspectors to keep the eye on these developments. So this was the first step for the working class in India. Foundation for what? Working class movement. Ilbert Bill controversy, 1883. Repeal of Vernacular Press Act. He said to the vernacular newspapers, "You go for the printing, but whatever you write about the government, it will be edited by the government officials." Hunter Commission, 1882, related to education. 53B. 54, consider the following statements. Rippon's era laid down the foundation of INC in India. See, Ilbert Bill, National Fund, National Conference, and then INC. Local self-government was the biggest gift of Rippon to India. Indians were demanding the share in their polity and administration. And Rippon gives them admission in nursery class. Both are true. 54C. 55, what was not done by Rippon? Not. Financial decentralization, it was done. Imperial head, provincial head, divided head. Redemption of Mysore, it was done. Reduction of salt duty, done. Military expedition to Tibet, this was done by Curzon, young husband. 1, 2, 4. Answer is C. What was true about Lytton Vernacular Press Act? Now Lytton, background, 1876 Lytton comes to India. He is an instigator, right in bracket, instigator, Vernacular Press Act. He instigates educated middle class. Lytton comes in the background when national movement is gaining ground in India. 1866, East India Association is formed. 1876, Indian Association is formed. So he comes with the objective to handle this tide of national movement. He comes with the objective to handle the birth of new industrialized nations. So important steps of Lytton. Vernacular Press Act. And this irritated educated middle class. Arms Act. This irritated influential class. Delhi Darbar. This irritated common people. Reduction in import duty. This irritated emerging industrialist. Civil service episode. This irritated
educated middle class, and then second Anglo-Afghan war. This irritated nationalist. So he came to suppress, he came to put off the fire in India. He opens the cylinder of oxygen. He instigates the fire. Instigator. Amrit Bazar Patrika turned into English from Bengali. S.N. Banerjee called it bold from blue. True. It was basically attack on library movement. Library movement. 80% illiteracy rate. So it was not possible for everyone to read the newspaper. So in every village, a cot was arranged. A literate person was arranged. And a newspaper was arranged. He used to sit on the cot and read and discuss the newspaper in front of the people. And that was called as library movement. It did not apply in Maratha Madras presidency. False. Answer is 1, 2, 3. 56. C. 57. Owen Meredith was the title of which viceroy? Lytton. Poet. Essayist. 57 C. 58. Consider the following statement. The statutory civil service was the creative of Lytton. Civil service. Examination starts in civil service from history of civil service. Very important. Civil service, steel frame of India. Policymakers. Who started CCS, Covenanted Civil Service? Initially, who recruited? It was the monopoly of Court of Directors. But then, Charter Act of 1853 introduced examination. But then English maintained the examination pattern in such a way that entering into civil service was a Herculean task for Indians. 1853 examination starts. 1864, first Indian to be ICS was Satyendranath Tagore. 11 years. But then also, in spite of all these hindrances, Indians entered into civil service. So Lytton says it is basically the urge of upper caste in India. Because they have maintained it from the time of Turks, Mughals, etc., etc. So statutory civil service, direct entry of upper caste. But if you have a talent to become the Prime Minister, why you will be satisfied by member of Legislative Assembly? So no one was interested in it. Finally, it was closed. First Afghan war was fought during the time of Lytton. Second, first was fought during Auckland. 58A, 59. Consider the following statement. Lytton ignited the educated middle class of India on the issue of civil service. We already discussed. By reduction in age limit. Lytton also got irritated by the emerging Indian industrialist. Both are true. So what he did? Reduction in import duty. I explained all the 6 points. 60. Arrange the following parties in ascending order. East India Association, 1866. Now the important point is not to mug up it. Important point is to see the evolution of organized nationalism. Evolution. East India Association, 1866. Dadabhai Naroji, London.
Objective, to inform the British people about the condition of India. Inform, not to fight. 1886, Indian Association to oppose the wrong policies of the government. Oppose, not to fight. Evolution, 1884, Madras Mahajan Sabha to raise the voice of cultivators, working class. And 1885, Indian National Congress. To make political demands, do social reforms, to work for the complete awakening of Indian masses at national level. Evolution. Dada Bhai Nauroji, Surendranath Banerjee, Anand Mohan Bose, Charlu, C. Rajgopal, Raghavachari, INC. Answer is C. 61. Commissions. Curzon. Curzon. Background. Again, background is important. Curzon arrives in India 1899. Curzon. 1899 to 1905. Now see the background. First background. National movement is gaining momentum. And second background. The new industrialized nations are expanding. National movement is gaining momentum. Extremists are raising their head. And industrialized nations are expanding. Germany, Italy, Russia, etc. So he has to handle these two objectives. Now, national movement. Fraser Commission. 1902 to deal with police department. This commission says the police department is indisciplined and inefficient. So a police training academy was established. Not only that, to strengthen the police department, a new department was established, CID. And this was to keep the eye on nationalist. Fraser Commission, police department. McDonald Commission. review the condition of famine. India was suffering from famine at that time. And this commission recommends for famine commissioners. The first important commission of famine was a Strachey Commission during the time of Lytton. Because the most important phenomenon of modern period is famines. Welby Commission, 1895. Moderns were talking about drain of wealth. The Welby Commission was appointed to review the income and expenditure of India. Acheson Commission, Indians were demanding their entry in civil services. So Acheson Commission was related to civil services, and that led to the birth of stratification in civil service, union service and state service. Answer is C, 61C. Consider the following statement, 62. Curzon followed aggressive foreign policy. True. I told you. Industrialized nations were expanding. France was active in Persia. Russians were active in Tibet. So he takes the aggressive foreign policy. Major Douglas was sent to Persia. The Shah of Prussia was brought to India. And young husband was sent to Tibet. He has to safeguard the borders of India from foreign enemies. Curzon created a new developed Department of Intelligence, CID. True. 62. Answer is C. Who compared Karzan with Aurangzeb, Gopal Krishna Gokhale? Because he says ki the same attitude, centralization, reformation, etc., etc. 63, see. 64, what was true about Curzon's University Act of 1905? Extremists are rising, extremists are gaining ground, and in mass politics, elders, they frame the policy. Youth, they implement the policy. So youth is a very important part of modern politics. Congress youth wing, BJP youth wing, Samajwadi youth wing. And from where that youth wing comes? College and universities. So see his university, University Act. Increase of official members in the Senate of University, correct. Periodical inspection of educational institutions by government officials, true. Strict affiliation rules to the colleges, true. Veto power in the hand of a senate of the university, true. All are true. And the motive was to control the entry of youth in national politics. But what he says, I want to improve the condition of higher education in India. 64A. Who among the following are related to Curzon? Moncrief, Robertson, Andrew Fraser, MacDonald, all of them. Moncrief Commission was related to irrigation. Robertson, the railway expert in India, who did the railway reforms in India. Andrew Fraser, Police Commission. MacDonald, famine. 65D. 66. Consider the following statement. Curzon strengthened the police department, we have already discussed. Curzon developed the state control on local bodies. Who gave the gift of local self-government to Indians? Ripon. But this gift of Ripon became the curse for British government. Reason? Act of 1892. Indirect election by local bodies. The government thought that the local bodies existence is on government, so the members of local bodies will be tilted towards government, but this did not happen. The members of local bodies were tilted towards nationalist. So to stop the entry of nationalists in the legislature, he has to maintain the control of local bodies. So you will see Calcutta Corporation Act of 1899. Increase of official members in local bodies. 66C, both are true. 67, R&D Department of Agriculture was established by Curzon in Bihar. 68, consider the following statement. Curzon was successful in controlling peasants to enter into national movement. India is an agricultural country. 80% people were involved in agriculture. And in mass politics, the strength is masses. So 80% are farmers in India. And if you appease these 80%, so what Curzon did? Agriculture reforms. Punjab Land Alienation Act. The non-farmer cannot take the land of a farmer. He saves the farmers from money lenders. Land resolution. End of force being used in the collection of land revenue. R&D department in agriculture. Promotion to irrigation. Cooperative banks to provide loans to the farmers at easier interest rate. So what is the reason for this love for the farmers? To appease the farmers. Because if 80% people are satisfied by the government, they will not participate in anti-government activities. And national movement will be weakened. So in Swadeshi movement, you will see only one incident, Marisal. He succeeds in it. Curzon was bothered about historical heritage of India. True. Student of history. Very much interested in history. So, Ancient Monument Act of 1904 by Curzon. And he passes £50,000 for the repair of historical monuments. He made the proposal for creating a museum for artifacts. So 68, C, both are true. 69, Raleigh Commission during the time of Curzon was related to education. 1902, Raleigh Commission, and on the recommendation of Raleigh Commission, University Act of 1904, which we have already discussed. 70, East is a university where a scholar never gets a degree was said by Curzon. He was influenced by the Sufi saints of this country, the spiritual knowledge of this country. He is a man who also said that India is a country of soccers and jugglers. But when he sees the cultural diversity, he sees the saints, Sufis, the spiritual achievement of India, then he says, East is a university where a scholar never gets a degree. 70A, Curzon-Kitchener conflict was related to army. So there were two members in Viceroy's Council, Commander-in-Chief and military member. Kitchener wanted, he was the Commander-in-Chief Kitchener. Kitchener wanted that this military member post should be abolished. And Curzon was against it. This was called as Curzon-Kitchener conflict. 71A, 72. Curzon tottering to its fall. Minto, group of seditious babus. Dufferin, microscopic minority. A.O. Hume, safety valve. 72D, opinion of personalities regarding Congress. Who was the viceroy who wanted Congress to work for social reforms? Dufferin. That is why in 1885, when Congress was formed, he gives tea party to the initial Congress delegates. And he proposes to them that Congress should work for social reforms, which was also proposed by B.M. Malbari in his newspaper, The Spectator. But it was opposed by A.O. Hume. And then Curzon calls, Dufferin calls Congress as a microscopic minority. 72D, 73A, 74, again the important events. A, Lord Harding to Gandhiji arrived in India. Chelmsford, Jallianwala Bagh. See the events, they're not simple events. Important, relevant. Reading Civil Service Exam Center in Delhi and London. Lord Irwin, Royal Commission for Agriculture. 74A, 75, portfolio system in India was the proposal of which viceroy? Canning, finance minister, home minister, defense minister. But it was included in the act of 1861. 75A, 76, famine commission were appointed during the time of Please do the correction here. They were appointed during the time of Lytton and Curzon. Please do the correction. It's Lytton and Curzon. MacDonald Commission during the time of Curzon. Strachey Commission during the time of Lytton. 77. Rebels of 1857 and their areas. It's a general question. So 77A. Revolt of 1857. There was never Turks were foreigners, Mughals were foreigners. They came from outside, but they turned into Indians. English? They came from outside and they remained outsiders, leading to economic exploitation, political exploitation, social exploitation, religious exploitation. And this revolt was the outcome of suppression and exploitation on all the fronts. So a general question, the leaders, 77A. 78, consider the following statement. Revolt of 1857 played a role of catalyst in national movement. True. After 1857, you see, when the national movement starts, and in Swadeshi movement, you have to pull out the women. So you gave the example of Rani Jhansi. That is why V.D.V. Savarkar calls it First War of Independence. So the characters of revolt of 87 were declared as a hero for the second phase of freedom struggle in India. The main feature of revolt of 1857 was Hindu-Muslim unity. Both are true. 78C. 79. 1857 was not the first revolt. There were a series of revolts. So 79 answer is A. V.D. Savarkar says, na, first war of independence. It was neither first nor war of independence. Well over mutiny. Religious symbols was the issue. Barakpur mutiny. Soldiers were not ready to cross the sea during Burma war. Ferozpur mutiny. And then 1816, Bareilly uprising. 79 answer is A. 80. 1857 book was written by S.N. Sen. 81. Who termed 1857 as a national revolt? Benjamin Disraeli. V.D. Savarkar called it First War of Independence because he has to use it as a catalyst in the second phase of freedom struggle. Benjamin Disraeli is the Prime Minister of Britain. He has to take over India from the company. So he has to give an excuse. And what was that excuse? National revolt. Ki the people of India do not want to live under the patronage of the company. And this became the important point for the transfer of power. So 81A. 82. What were factors responsible for the revolt of 1857? The new Enfield rifle. True. The issue of Greece cartridges. Lex Lockheed Law. Lex Lockheed Law. 1850. Religious Disability Act. Very important. If a Hindu converts towards Christianity, his right in paternal property will not end. This was considered by Hindus as a step to promote conversion in India. Religious Disabilities Act, true. Inam Commission, true. Ending the previous titles, etc., etc. So all of them. 82A. British officers during the revolt. Very important. You have to do, I always say, limitations of the time. In this paper, once the discussion is over, you have to do the homework. Don't stop here. Take all these officers, their role, any specific contribution. 83, answer is D. 84, who according to Canning was helpful for British for not joining the revolt? Scindia. 84, B. 85, what were considered as the evidence about revolt being planned? It's an assumption. Roaming sannyasis and fakirs, red lotuses, chapatis, distribution of religious text. 85A. What were the reasons behind revolt of 1857? Every section of society was extremely economically exploited. True. Farmers, zamindars, old ruling class. Doctrine of lapse and subsidiary alliance were a big setback to the rulers. Friendship and betrayal. A very good example of Avadh. Abolition of old customs like sati, widow remarriage also hurt the sentiment of the people. True. Promotion to modern education in English medium. 1, 2, 3. 86D. 87. Again, the rebel leaders, you have to add their contributions. 87A. 88. What was true about Tatya Tope, commander of Bajirao II? And Bajirao II original name was Dhodupant. Bajirao II. Let's see what was true about Tatya Tope. He was the commander of Rana Sahib. True. His original name was Ramchandra Pandurang. True. He was deceived by the feudal lord of Sindhya Man Singh. True. He was hanged in Gwalior. True. 88A. All are true. Huzoor Daftar during the time of Peshwa was related to administration. It was the secretariat of Peshwa administration. 89A. 90. Consider the following statements. Lytton ignited the feeling of national movement in India. True. I gave you the chart. He is instigating each and every section. Middle class, nationalist, industrialist, common people. William Bentinck became the messiah for middle class in India. Education, press. Both are true. 90C. 91. Mohammad Shah Rangila sent his court artist to bring the portrait of Bajirao I. 92. Consider the following statements. Dalhousie was the creator of modern India. True. The engines of changes. Telegraph, railway, postal. End of the old ruling structure. What Napoleon did in Europe. End of monarchies. The same thing Dalhousie did in India, etc., etc. Duple gave the key of conquest of India to EIC, policy of kingmaker and subsidiary alliance. 92C. 93. What was true about Bajirao I? Battle of Palkhet gave him supremacy over Nizam. 6 Mughal provinces. He takes the Chauth and Sardesh Mukhi from 6 Mughal provinces. Bundela's invitation gave him the control on Bundelkhand. Chhatrasal invites him. He was successful in exposing the weakness of Mughal Empire. While on expedition to Bundelkhand, he takes a picnic trip to Delhi in 1737 and no one opposes him. He was considered as a fighting Peshwa. All are true. 93A. 94. The post of Sena Karte created by Shah who related to army. 94A. 95. Who among the following became the victim of impatience and lack of experience against English? Sirajuddaula. Battle of Plassey. When he leaves the battlefield on the advice of Mir Jafar and then his army surrenders. Tipu Sultan, Travancore episode. Bajirao II, the threat was on his head and he was instigating his own. 95D, 1 and 2, Shiraz and Tipu Sultan. 96, who among the following strengthened the foundation of British rule in India? Who laid down the foundation? Duple and Clive. Who strengthened the foundation? Warren Hastings and Cornwallis. Administrative reforms, judicial reforms, revenue reforms. 96D. Siyarul Mukhtakarni is the history of Bengal. Who's the author? Ghulam Hussain. Main story, he neglects the story of Black Hole Tragedy. Black Hole Tragedy is not mentioned in his book. 97A. 98. Which Governor General was killed in Andaman? Mayo. 98C.
99, consider the following statements. Shimla Conference, 1945, please do the correction. It's 1905 is wrong, 1945. Shimla Conference of 1945 was organized to discuss the partition of India. No, it was organized to discuss about provisional government. Havel Plan of 1945 says, ki provisional government will be formed, which will have the representation of all the political parties. And if the members of all the political parties will come to a common consensus, Constituent Assembly will be formed. So it was attempt to form a provisional government having the members from all the political parties so that they can have Constituent Assembly. But then it became the victim of Jinnah's demency. Naval mutiny took place during the time of Lord Wavell. True. Both are true. What is related to Lord Linlithgow? V.D. Savarkar became the president of Hindu Mahasabha, yes, 1938. INA was formed in Singapore, 1943. Forward Bloc was formed by Subhash Chandra Bose, true. Muslim League celebrated Liberation Day, 1939, by the resignation of Congress ministries. So friends, second paper is over. Your advices are welcome. If you find any new If you want any change, if you want any addition in all these papers, you please, your advisors will be welcome on the official site of IQRA and on YouTube. Thank you.